Anything Dave, I'm ready to listen to.
Dave can do it all. Welcome back to the channel, TNT Reacts. Thank you for all the support. Subscribe if it's your first time here. Drop some suggestions below. We'll be taking all our suggestions. You're giving us some fire to listen to.
Yeah.
Let's get into Dave Leslie featuring Ruel. This was the Dave album cover for his album Psycho.
Oh, really?
Crazy, right?
Yeah, I like that.
It's also his merch.
Blue Flames.
Yeah, it looks so dope with the head.
Yeah. Look, they say the universe, it works in a strange way. And it must be true because we ain't from the same background or same place. But me and Leslie ended up on that same train. I'm talking every day. I used to wake up around 7 or 8 to catch the 906 on Norbury Station. Two different worlds in the same location. And one day we ended up speaking. And I would talk about college, she would talk about meetings and how she's planning on leaving. How she hates what she does but she needs it. I asked her what she would do when it's the weekend. And she said, I don't know myself. I don't know myself.
Yo, the storytelling.
Yeah.
He's so versatile to be able to do songs like Clash and Verdance.
And then to do songs like
and
this.
Then,
yeah.
And he's singing this hook.
Yeah.
I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. She used to be the life of the party for true. And now she going out hardly ever. Her man got her in the yard forever. And her friends wanna help, but it's hard to tell her. Hard to let her know that her man's possessive and aggressive. And she can't even see it, but for them it's clear as day. She's in a situation. Her friend Hannah had a man that was manipulative. So she can see it from a mile off. Turtleneck jumpers, makeup around the eye spots.
Damn. Okay.
She can see it from a mile off. Turtleneck jumpers, makeup around the eye spots. All the signs were there. But Leslie made it seem a light affair. Said it wasn't right to share. Her boyfriend, he was a mystery man. Didn't know much about him, but he's been in a can. Name's Jason. He's a bad boy with no reasoning. To be honest, I don't know what Les sees in him. Cause she's a good girl with a sweetheart. But they both got demons in a deep past. You know, opposites attract, apparently. Never heard her talk about her family ever. He was all that she had until they had an argument and he stopped calling her back. And I don't know if there was more to the story than that. Cause she plays things down, but according to that, he went missing one day in the morning. He ran. She's doing overtime, struggling to afford in a flat. Till she lost her job, it fucked all of her plans. Couldn't pay the rent, borrowing and calling for cash. But Hannah, she was there for her, care for her. When I saw Les, she told me, I don't know myself, I don't know myself no more. Les saying I got nothing to live for, it's been raw, but David, I ain't never been this poor. There's no income, my boyfriend left me, so how the fuck am I gonna survive when his kid's born? And I said it's a blessing, as mad as it is. And Les, I never even knew that you were having a kid. Bro, she's 4 months pregnant, young and neglected, single, but I don't think she wants to accept it. So she's still texting exes, trying to get this back on track, but I don't think that she gets it.
Damn,
this is not what I expected.
Yo,
some real life shit.
And he's still rapping in it.
Yeah,
he's not just, yo,
it's emotional obsession. Don't think that she gets it. It's emotional obsession, clinical depression. Life is a lesson. You ain't gotta sit and cry. It's Leslie living in this gift called life. There's no better gift than the gift of life. So can you handle it? I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. But that changed her perspective. Late in December, her baby's expected to drop. She's accepted, excited, electric, pumped. Only gotta wait a few months. Her and Hannah had lunch, told her she's pregnant. And they're the closest of brethren, so she didn't stunt to tell her. I think that it's an error. You ain't a mum for a day, you're a mum forever.
You ain't a mum for a day, you're a mum forever. Call your mom, people.
Whatever, and you and Jason break up whenever. If I'm honest, that's something you should have done together. She doesn't know that her and Jason going out again, and Jason doesn't know that Leslie's carrying a child for them. She...
Wait, go back. Wait, what?
I missed something. They said something earlier I wasn't sure about. I think Hannah was dating Jason before Leslie.
Let me go back.
Break up whenever. If I'm for a day, you're a mum forever. Whatever. And you and Jason break up whenever. If I'm honest, that's something you should have done together. She doesn't know that her and Jason going out again, and Jason doesn't know that Leslie's carrying a child for them.
Okay, if I'm not mistaken, Hannah and Jason are going out, and Leslie's pregnant.
Yeah, with Jason's kid.
That Hannah doesn't
know. Hannah and Leslie are like besties.
All right.
She had daydreams of settling down with Jason. Better cause now they're together, it's wild. Feeling like she needs to call her friends and tell them, cause wow, she's letting them down, but most of them are never around. She calls Hannah the next day, still trying to figure out the best way to tell her that she's getting back together with an ex-flame. So she left her a voicemail, like, yo Hannah, it's Les, can you call me back? I wanna talk about the baby, you, me, Jason, all of that. I've been feeling like I need to get my aura back. I used to be so fucking confident, but these days, I swear that I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. It's 3:30, Leslie was meant to get a scan, but today I think she's going home early, trying to talk to Jason, tell him about the kid, addressing any reservations, have that conversation, middle of the summer and it's raining, waiting at the train station, hella cancellation, so she gets a taxi, sitting in the backseat, blue jean jacket and a maxi, actually tired and her legs are aching, touch the destination, way faster than a cab driver's estimation. She put the key in the door, she couldn't believe what she see on the floor. Some size 5 trainers, raging, tears in her eyes, but it's cool, cause they must be the neighbors. And Jason's in a bedroom, fully naked. Leslie running up the stairs, but she's making noise. And she can hear Jason's voice saying, hide in the closet, but he's made his choice, so she bursts in, saying, what kind of person would cheat on his pregnant girlfriend? Jason saying, what the fuck, you're pregnant, what the fuck? You weren't even gonna tell me, I mean, what the fuck? What do you want from us? Nah, you ain't in love, you just wanna love. Leslie telling Jason, I don't wanna love. I don't wanna you and I don't wanna us. And also, I don't wanna talk loads. One more line before I dash like Morse code, open the...
Still with bars even in a song like
naturally.
This. Yo, this storytelling is insane. Because he's setting the scene.
Yeah.
The way he described, like, the cab.
Yeah.
And like her in the backseat, yeah, like yeah. you feel like you're there. This is
feels
crazy.
Feels like I'm reading a book.
Yeah. So I don't want to talk loads. One more line before I dash like Morse code. Open the wardrobe. Jason's on the edge. I just want to see if she was prettier than me, slimmer than me. Maybe your baby similar to me. Maybe you wanted someone thicker than me, fitter than me, to satisfy you quicker than me. I got your baby in my stomach and you did this to me. What did I ever do to you for you to finish with me? I didn't believe my girls, but they were thinking of me. And give it to me, the wardrobe, give me the key. I was pulling at the door, but Jason's bigger than me. Literally, I remember viscerally, Jason pulling from behind me, now he's gripping on me. White flash, eye gashes when he's hitting me, see. I just wanted to disappear, I wasn't living for me. Physically, I shut the fucking doors quick as can be. He's outside asking why I made him do what he did. Using a kick to open up the room that I'm in. I'm feeling afraid, barricaded with a chair and a handle. I'm hearing sirens, I just wanna run away, but I can't. Jason's gone by the time police are coming. They saw that there ain't no one else in the house, and feds are running through the door shouting. We had reports of an argument with a woman. There's blood all over the floor and it's splattered onto the wall. There's Lee's on the bed and she's trying to speak to the feds. She's deep in the stress and his meter's above her head. If anything, she couldn't even say anything. But she's got this really sharp pain where her belly is, so they call the ambulance. Leslie didn't plan for this. Police are in the room trying to find a missing piece of the puzzle until they stumble on something that's kind of random. It's a phone in a wardrobe. They had 5 missed phone calls from Jason and also a couple other numbers, so they're thinking that it's no help. They played a voicemail like, yo Hannah, it's Les, can you call me back? I want to talk about the baby, you, me, Jason, all of that. I've been feeling like I need to get my aura back. I used to be so fucking confident, but these days I swear that I don't know myself. I don't know myself no more. She felt sick to her stomach, she started panicking, mind rattling, trying to understand what Hannah did. Battling the shame, cause the situation embarrassing. She's trying to fathom it, betrayed by her own garrison. Meanwhile, she's on the deck trying to manage this. Piercing pain in her stomach, she couldn't handle it. Now she's waiting for an ambulance.
Look. Yo, we can't stop this. Yeah. I just want to say, like, it's... I want to stop and say things, but like, you can't get off the story.
Yeah.
It's crazy. I was going to ask you, though. You said garrison. Isn't that something they use in Jamaica?
We call kind of like the ghetto garrison.
Right. You're saying so, part of her crew, I guess,
right? I mean,
right?
That's what I
know. Yeah. Damn, this is some... You know what's crazy? Dave was 19 when he did this album.
Really?
Wow. Yeah. Because, I think it was 20, whatever year it was. Yeah. He was 19, I think.
Yeah.
And I know she's strong, but when I heard about what happened, I was overshocked. Her nose was gone, her jawline shattered and rot. They said her baby was the reason she was holding on. She's dozing off, doctors getting no response. Her heart rate slowing down and they don't know what's wrong. Picked her up, got her out the home and onto the stretcher for good measure, but she's fading out. She took damage to the brain and now she's in a coma as we speak, but I ain't sure if she can make it out. You see, this time that I'm taking out to tell you the story is more than a song or track. It's a message to a woman with a toxic man. I'm begging you to get support if you're lost or trapped. I understand that I can never understand, and I ain't saying that it's easy, but it must be right. Some of your sisters, aunties, mums and wives are fucked inside and they will never touch on why. I'm touched cause I've seen women that I loved or liked cry a little red tear through a bloodshot eye. This shit's awful. No matter what culture, it ain't normal. Men try and twist it and make it seem like it's your fault. In that train full of people that you're taking, how many Leslies are running from their Jasons?
Bro, I got goosebumps.
Jesus. Yo, it's so powerful. I don't even want to go back.
This is another Love is Blind by Eve and Faith Evans.
Yeah, damn.
That's wow.
I'm sorry, I had to go back. I didn't want to go. It felt like that moment was...
Don't like, aside, and they will never touch on why. I'm touched because
it's so true.
Yeah.
It's so
true. I've seen women that I loved or liked cry a little red tear through a bloodshot eye. This shit's awful. No matter what culture, it ain't normal. Men try and twist it and make it seem like it's your fault. In that train full of people that you're taking, how many Leslies are running from their Jasons?
Angel without wings, like the day without the night to bring her peace. A song without a voice, a spark without a flame, a job without a name. Oh, it's just wrong. Like an ocean without a shore, a soldier without a war. How can we do this? Song without a voice, a spark without a flame, a child without a name. Oh, it's just wrong.
Wow. That was emotional.
That was crazy. Wow.
Fire upon a boy where I beat Oman. Fire upon the boy them where I kill Oman. I want to forget it.
Yo, there's still a minute, but I think that's really the song. Yo, Dave tells
this. He definitely saw, like, people. He said it, but just him even doing the song. You don't see rappers doing songs like this, really.
Right? And it, right? He didn't.
When's the last time a rapper did something like this?
About domestic violence.
Yeah.
It wasn't some, I'd say corny, but that, like.
Nah, this was deep. This was almost, gangsta math, I keep it, you know, but.
Yeah. Damn. Yo, this song was 11 minutes long. It never felt like it. The whole time you're in the story, you're trying to see what's going to happen.
Woman, don't stay in that situation.
Right.
Yeah, it's not, and I know it's not easy to leave. He said it, but you know, nah, it's not worth it.
The crazy thing about this, right, is you know what the message is?
Yeah.
He doesn't just start off with a message. He gives you a story and then hits you with the message at the point that you're so in the story. And then the last line is, on the train that you're taking, so how many Leslies running from their
Jasons? But I'm not saying beats are that bad. Beats are bad. Broken jaw.
Yeah. Thing. And we don't even really know what happened.
She probably died. Her heart rate slowed down. She's pregnant. There's extra stress on the body. Nah.
Yeah, this is... Wait, hold up. Is this a real story? Is this some story he knew from, like, growing up?
Changed the names, maybe? Yeah, I don't know.
Let us know if this is a real story. I mean, it's a real story. There might be.
He probably has an article about the song or an interview about
the song. We can find out, right? Wow.
If you guys know, maybe you guys heard something we haven't heard. But wow, that was a lot.
This guy.
This is like a Love is Blind type.
Right? You know? Yeah. Yeah. This is insane. You know, Dave, incredible job, incredible message. Yeah. Thank you all for watching the video. Give us some more suggestions in the comments below. Like, comment, subscribe.
Subscribe.
Let me see you.